Don't be someone that will build lots of castles with your mouth, and at the end of the day, you can't deliver.
There are things you need to do to stay powerful if you're already powerful, if you're already doing these things. There are little things that can make someone fall from the place of power. Hello, good morning, good afternoon, good evening from wherever you're watching from. Welcome to once again to AZH Meets Variety Corner. If you're watching me for the first time, a very warm welcome to you. Okay, so if you have not yet subscribed to this channel, please consider subscribing, okay, and also click on the bell button, all right, so that you will be the first person to be notified when next we upload a new video. Also, guys, please don't forget to like, share, comment, all right? I want to see your comments concerning this particular topic, all right? And what are we talking about today? We're going to be discussing about how to be powerful. Yes, how to be powerful in life. So what are the things that we should start doing if we've not yet started doing them? What are the things that will make us powerful? One, talk less. I'm going to come with some other parts because there are so many laws of power. There are so many things that will make you powerful. There are so many things that make you remain in power, and there's so many things that preserves your dignity as a man, as a woman, irrespective of who you are or where you are or whatever circumstances you find yourself in or any position you think you are in. You want to be powerful? Always say the truth. You want to be powerful? Even when your advice is needed, think properly. Chew the words well and make sure that you say the truth and nothing but the truth. You want to be powerful? Be a man or woman of your word. Don't be a chameleon. Don't be a hypocrite. Do not be somebody that when you see red, you become red color. When you see blue, you become blue. When you see black, hey, you are black color. You've got no stand of your own. You will lose power. You can't be powerful that way. Powerful does not mean fighting, flexing of muscle, or intimidating or oppressing people around you because you feel you can do it and get away with it. Even the book of Proverbs have already said it, that we have the power of life and death on our tongue. And that same proverb said that even when a fool, the total fool, keeps quiet, that person is considered wise. People begin to look at you as a wise person. A man, and you feel that you're being powerful is for you to be beating your wife, intimidating her, oppressing her and the children, or you come inside the house and you become a lion of the tribe of your house. You talk so much to the extent that you cause havoc to people's lives and their homes and families. You have lost power. You can't be powerful doing that. Okay? Even the word of God said that he who tames his tongue, if you tame your tongue, you learn, begin to, even though it's not in your character, begin to learn it. Okay? Begin to work on yourself on some certain things. It is very, very important. Don't give unsolicited advice. Something that that is none of your business. Learn to keep quiet. Learn to be a good listener. Even when people ask for your advice, chew your word very well. Think deeply, because a word, once it goes out, you can't take them back. Talk too much. You begin to say irrelevant things. You begin to say useless things. You begin to say things that will not benefit anybody. When you talk too much, you begin to lie, because there are no more things for you. There are no more useful things you can say.
And the moment people begin to know you as a liar, dear, forget it. You have lost power. Talkative cannot make you powerful. And some of us are so good in saying irrelevant things. That is why when you call people on the phone, they don't want to pick. Because they know it's either one gossip or the other. They know that there's nothing important you've got to say. Please let us begin to work on ourselves. It's very important. You must be disciplined to be powerful. Our God is a disciplined God. That was why when Adam and Eve, you know, they ate the apple and so that is the story for another day. What did God do? God drove them out of the Garden of Eden. And that gave your respect if you're a man by talking down on your wife. You can't. There is no how you can. Those people, the people you are talking to, they will actually, they can be gingering you up and all that. But don't forget, they will be the ones to laugh at you. So it is important. Be a straightforward person. Let your yes be yes and let your no be no. These are general laws that will help us to remain in place of power. It's not about making so much noise. There are actually three major things you use to dictate a powerful person. Part two. So watch out, guys. Don't forget to subscribe. Talk less. You're someone that will build lots of castles with your mouth. And at the end of the day, you can't deliver. Keep your plans to yourself most of the times. And let people actually see the results. Then later you can share your testimonies. But some of us, you talk so much to the extent that you will even any plans or anything you've got, you talked to, they're actually waiting to see those things come to be. They're waiting for you to deliver. But at the end of the day, you've got nothing to show. You've got nothing to deliver. And then if at all they've got some percentage of respect for you, you lose it. It is gone. So please, let us take note of all these things. I'm coming back to tell us the three major things you have to work on. Apart from your tongue, apart from the way you talk, your comportment. That will be a part two of today's topic. Okay? So stay blessed. If you're a returning subscriber, I love you so much. Thank you so very much. Look, you are the best. Look, you are a king. You are a royalty. Honestly, you are the best. I don't know what to say. But let God bless you for me. You are the point of your needs. I really appreciate it. Thank you, guys. We've come this far. All the chimneys, you are blessed. God bless you. Honestly, I love you. I love you. Thank you very much. Please don't forget to like, comment, share. Let other people know about this. Let other people learn. Please let us not be selfish, okay? Let other people learn about what it takes. You know, everybody wants power. Everybody wants, okay, to be powerful. But at times, maybe because of our upbringing or because of the environment where we grew in, we get everything to the opposite, okay? And that actually makes us to lose power instead of gaining it. All right, begin to say irrelevant, help us all. Please don't forget to like, share, comment, and don't forget to click on the bell button, okay? So that when next we upload a new video, you will be the first to be notified. Thank you very much for always being there. Okay, bless you. I love you so much. Bye-bye.